Welcome to new video. Today we are going to discuss about digital systems design. The digital systems are spread to wide range of applications including computer, mobile phones, control systems. Digital system deals with different types of elements such as hardware, software, and network and their applications. If you combine these elements together and form a system is called as digital systems design. There are many different components that designs a system. Let's go through the overview of today's topics. Then we will get to know more about basics of VLSA designs. Digital systems design is economical and easy to program. It is easy to duplicate similar circuits and complex digital ICs using microelectronics technology. Digital systems design in embedded system can able to reduce the size and cost of the product. Data is represented in a digital system as a vector of binary variables. They can provide accuracy and runs with less noise. Digital systems are less prone to error than analog systems. Data representation in a digital system is suitable for error detection and correction. Digital electronics is a field of electronics involving the study of digital signals and to produce devices. Digital electronics circuits are usually made from large assemblies of logical gates packaged in integrated circuits. VLSA is the abbreviation of very large scale integration. It is the process of creating single chip by using integrated circuit. In 1970, when most integrated circuit chips were widely used to enable complex semiconductor and electronic devices, then VLSA technology started its footprint. The knowledge of digital electronics along with strong base knowledge in VHDL or Verilog HDL are so important. Final state machine and first in first out are the techniques used in the logic design of VLSA circuits. VLSA devices are microprocessors and microchips. They can perform more complex functions. The main advantages of VLSA technology are easiness to IC designers to add major components like CPU, ROM, RAM, etc. into one chip. VLSA term originated according to number of transistors or gates used into a chip. VLSA chips are used in mobile phones, cars, medical devices, and many other places. Before VLSA, most ICs had limited functions. As technology grows fast, there is a constant need to design, develop integrated circuits. Since products like mobile phones are released with new features very often, VLSA technology is still in high demand. With the help of VLSA, there is an increase in operating speed of circuits. The downside of the VLSA are high level of knowledge and skills are required in electronics related fields to understand VLSA technology. In VLSA, the programming languages used for integrated circuit designs are called hardware description languages. The hardware description languages include VHDL, Verilog, and System Verilog. Hardware description languages used for different architectures allows the design to be simulated earlier in the design cycle in order to correct errors. The most common hardware description languages used for integrated circuit designs are Verilog HDL and VHDL. Whereas in embedded systems are based on microcontrollers used to develop FPGA-based embedded applications. In embedded systems, they perform special tasks so digital designs increase the performance and reliability of the product. Verilog is a hardware description language used to provide high level of software programs that a microprocessor executes. Verilog is used as an input for synthesis programs which will generate a gate-level description for the circuit. Some Verilog constraints are not synthesizable, so it affects the size and speed of the synthesized circuit. It also defines constraints that it can be used to control input and output of simulation. Verilog has a better grasp on hardware modeling, but it has a lower level of programming constraints. Verilog is not as verbose as VHDL, so it's more compact. There are four levels of abstractions: are algorithmic level, register transfer level, gate level, and switch level. VHDL is very high-speed integrated circuit hardware description language. VHDL is more verbose than Verilog, and it is also has a non-C-like syntax. With VHDL, you have a higher chance of writing more lines of code. VHDL is a hardware description language that can be used to model a digital system. The digital system can be as simple as logic gate or as complex like computer chips. It is used in electronic design automation to describe digital and mixed signal systems such as integrated circuits. The digital system or structure is made up of large modules, and within each module there is a flow of instructions like a software program with variables, control flow, conditions, and loop. Each module has one or more inputs along with one or more outputs. The inputs are specified within a structure called an entity. VHDL provides different types of constraints called design units. They are entity declaration, architecture body, configuration declaration, package declaration, and package body. Digital electronics is basic building concept focused in VLSI. There are combinational and sequential circuits, logic gates, and finite state machines are used in digital electronics. VHDL or Verilog uses in system programming. The scripting languages uses like Perl or TCL. Verilog or system Verilog work on building verification using methods like UVM or OVM. Thank you for watching our video. Please stay tuned for upcoming digital systems design tutorials.